Hello everyone. So today we are created JSON API in NPM 6.3. So yes, you heard it right. Our favorite JSON API has been deprecated from AEM 6.3, and AEM has provided us two alternatives for this. One is JSON and another one is JSON. So in my demo video, I am going to discuss serialization and deserialization of Java objects from and to JSON. So we will add this Maven dependency from our pom.xml. So first of all, we will discuss about serialization. So here I am going to take an example from where I am going to fetch all the children from a particular page and get the data from that. Like, let me show you. I have just assumed, actually I have decided that I want a JSON like that, and there can be multiple pages like that. There will be information of multiple pages. Like, there will be an object and there will be another object. So we can validate it through JSON. Okay, yes, this is my valid JSON, and now I am converting it to POJOs. So this is my online converter tool, POJO. This is POJO converter, and I have just copied my entire JSON over here, and I just got my POJOs. So I copied these two POJOs in my model classes. These two are my model classes, and okay, I think I have a wrong package name. So my package name is supposed to be code.jsonsample. Okay, so yes, one thing to note over here, that it has shown me the tag attributes POJO like array, but it is good to use tag attributes. So I prefer tag attributes. So let's change it according to your requirements. Okay, just remove the getters and setters of it as well. Okay, I think I just need to add tag attributes. There is a list of tag attributes, and I just need to generate a getter and setter for this particular thing. Okay, so this is the thing. So I am done with my POJOs. Now let's take an example. In a servlet, what I am supposed to do, I am just getting a resource. This can be any resource. I will just hard code some value for my basic understanding. Request dot get resource resolver dot get resource, and I will enter some page path like /content/v-retail, and I will, this is a page, so I will adapt these resource to a page. So actually what I'm trying to do is, I'm just trying to get all the children of this particular page and format the information of those pages, those children pages, in this manner. So okay, so I have adapted this resource to a page. Now I will bring children, iterator of page, iterator page dot list children. Okay, now while iterator dot has next, if there is something has next, so page child page is equal to iterator dot next. So okay, so we need to create a list of this particular object over here, page model. So we have multiple page model objects, so we will create a list of page model. We can make it like page list is equal to new array list. Okay, so what I will do next is I need to add the all the tags of this page in an array. So I need to get so tag is equal to child page dot get tags. In the for loop we can add tag colon tags, and in this we need to create a list of tag attributes. Tag list actually. I think it has some wrong. Okay. JSON sample. So that's why it's showing me the wrong import statement. Okay. So these are all tags. I'm getting these tags. And I need to add these tags to a list. So tag list dot add. So it is good to make a constructor. Actually, so I need to add a constructor over here. It's not mandatory, it's just how you write the code, so it's up to you. New tag attributes. Now tag dot get name comma tag dot get. Okay, so my list of tag is ready, and now when I come outside I need to add page list dot add. Now I need to write page dot get child page dot get path comma child page dot get name comma tag list. Sorry, and again we need to make a constructor over it, and we need to create an object for this. So new page model. And we need to write everything under this, and in the page model we need to write generate, we need to write a constructor. I think there is something in the constructor. Okay, there is something change in the constructor. There is a page name. So get name in starting, then tag list comma this. So this is how we are done. So now we just need to convert this page list object to our JSON through JSON. So new JSON, and here JSON dot to JSON, and from object so page list. So we can just directly write it to some response. So we can just see the resp dot get writer dot print and we just see the response over here. So we need to build the code. I need JSON, so it will be more relevant. MVM clean install hyphen p auto install package. So it will take its time to build the code. I hope you just understand what I have written. So in the meanwhile, I just go to the hierarchy. We have this content slash v hyphen retail pages there. So under v retail there are multiple pages, so I need to adjust some tags to some pages so that we can, you know, get some data in the JSON. I don't know why it takes too long. You just load a page. So something got failed. So there is problem with some another class, Jackson Simple Servlet. So I can remove this class, I don't need this. So delete and let the code build once again. Meanwhile, I just see what is going on over here. So I just need to add some tags. Okay, let me add some tags over here. Let me add one more variation. Let me see if the code is built. Okay, it is downloading something. So meanwhile, I just let you know some more things over here that we can, you know, just do some pretty formatting of these JSON. So how we can do this? So we can do something like this. JSON is equal to new JSON builder dot is something like pretty set pretty printing dot create. So it will just create a pretty formatting of my JSON. So we have this thing as well with, so if we have, you know, we want to show in a good look of my JSON, so I can show it like that. Okay, it will take some more time to do its own things. Okay, let's discuss the deserialization as well till it got built. So how deserialization work? So we know that this particular thing gives me the data in the JSON format. So let me put in JSON and something like this. So maybe you are getting JSON somewhere and you just need to, you know, convert it into Java objects. So there is nothing much left in that. You just need to create these POJO classes. Same part will play over there. Models part will be played over there. You just need to change the things here. So what you can do, JSON one, let's suppose there's no need of this line as well. Okay. So what you can do, you can just JSON dot from JSON. So here you need from JSON. So for just do JSON dot from JSON, and we can just add the JSON and what the JSON is returning. So if it is returning, you know, list of page model or, you know, just an array, so here it will statement like this. It will need to write page model dot class. So it is something like that. So we just need to know that how the data is coming through JSON, and then we need to convert it to some Java object through JSON. So okay, the code is already built. Now I just hit the servlet and I can see that yeah, it is same as I have expected it to be. It is same like this JSON data. So let me validate it as well. Yes, it is a valid JSON. So it is, this is what I was expecting. So there is no tag, so there is no tag information in the ch page. So this is an empty field. So it is showing me all the values which I have entered. Let me build it once again. So I just want to see a pretty the data in the pretty format. So okay, let me do this as well. And again I want to see that how many objects are there, so we can just get it in the response. So you can see that the size is page. Page model dot length. So we can write it like that. Again we need to build the code. So here you have seen that this is the serialization, because we are converting a JSON data to a model, and this particular thing is serialization. So the benefit of JSON is we can, you know, create the complex structures of JSON in a very, very simpler way. So the code is getting built. It will take some more moments. And one more thing I would like to add, that JSON is used for small Java objects, small JSON or small Java objects. So if you have some less amount of data, so yes, we have a pretty view, and you can see the size is 8. So we have 8 children over here. You can count it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, we have 8 children. So it is showing me data as per the 8. So we can get the Java objects from JSON and vice versa. So this is all about serialization and deserialization of JSON. Thank you.